Hi everyone, good morning. This is Mazhar and we are learning how to crack Maths SAR exam. For the students who are looking to crack it, so here I'm going to show you the shortcut tricks as well as how to save your time within for solving this sort of question. So let us solve and check what questions is there for the practice SAT test 3 that I have taken. The first question, a painter will paint n walls with the same size and shape. So this is what you have to carefully read it and just underline what is given to us in a building using a specific brand of paint. Okay. What is the expression given to us? Quickly, we'll come to that. This is the expression that is given, NKLH, where n is the number of walls, k is constant with unit dollars. Okay, this is the rate per square foot. L is the length and H is the height. So if the customer asks the painter to use more expensive brand, okay, so what is changing? What expression would change? So as I said, number of walls, no, it won't affect. Height and L also won't affect because they are of the same size and shape. So what will affect for the customer if he goes for the more expensive brand? The constant, the unit rate per square foot, that matters to him. So that is what quickly you can do. Now moving on to the second question. If 3 times r is equals to 18, what is the value of the expression 6 times r plus 3? So first get the value of r from that, whatever is available, that is dividing by 3 will give you 6. So just plug in here, 6r plus 3 is means 6 times 6 plus 3. 36 plus 3 is 39. You're done with your answer. Moving on to the third one, which is of the which of the following is equal to a raised to 2 by 3 for all values of a. So this is like exponential form. So what we can do is I can do it in two ways. It can be split up into this one, power of a power, or I can bring the power. I can switch, okay, as per the exponential law. So now just try and check what is the exact form, what is given, which is equivalent to this one. 1 by 3rd, as we know, it is nothing but the cube root. So these two rules out because they are the squares. So among this, which one? D1. Moving on to the fourth one, the number of states that joined the United States between these 1776 years and 1849 is twice the number of states that joined between these years. We just need to write this in the form of, okay, algebraic equation. So which one among that would be the appropriate? So first write it down what is given to us. So 1776 to 1849 is twice between the years 1850 and 1900. And this they have given it as X. It is given in the question. You can check here. X states joined because we don't know how many. And this one they have given specific number 30. Now check where is it? It is an A. So this is your answer. Moving on to the fifth one. If 5 by x is equal to 15 by x plus 20, what is the value of x by 5? Again, we need to work it out and get x first. Then we can easily plug in this one. So whenever such algebraic fractions and equations are given, just try and think like we can directly simplify it. Yes, we can do that numerator and numerator, 5 times 3. So it gives you a lesser value rather than multiplying with the bigger value. So now this will be like x plus 20 is equals to 3x. As we all know, when we have a same variable between the, like on the other side of the two equations, we try and bring it together. So if I shift this the other side or bring the like terms together, I'm going to get this one. So x is equals to 10 if I divide by 2 on both sides. So when x is 10, the substitute here, 10 over 5 will give you 2. This is your answer. Now moving on to the sixth one, which is given to us in the form of a simultaneous equation in two variables, x and y. So how to solve simultaneous equations? We have various ways. Like we can do it with elimination, substitution, crisscross, and determinant. So I'm going to do with the elimination because that will give me the quick answer. So what is the rule for the simultaneous elimination method is you need to have either x and y coefficient should be same. Whereas here we can find that they aren't. They are 2, 3, 3, 2. So we need to make it equal. So I'm multiplying this with 3, this with 2. 6x minus 9y, 14 threes are is 42. Similarly, 6x minus 4y equals to negative 12. Sign won't change. Only the thing is you are multiplying respectively with that numbers. Now, in order to eliminate, we know one has to be positive and negative. So since they are same, both are positive. So I'm trying to change the second equation with the sign. So what it, if it is positive, it changes to negative, negative, positive, negative, positive. So while solving, you don't have to look at the previous sign. You just have to look at the new sign. 6 minus 6 minus 9 plus 4 is negative 5y. This will give you 30. So y is equals to 6. So upon getting y is equals to 6, what you're trying to get x, because we need x and y, remember. Plug it in any one. If I just substitute in the second one, 3x minus 2 times 6. So 3x minus 12 minus 6. Upon shifting it to the other side, the sign changes to positive. Now x is equals to 2. So once you have x and y, he asked us to find out and work it out x minus y. So 2 minus 6 will give you negative 4. That is your answer. Moving on to the next one, we have a function. We know x and f of x is nothing but this is input and this is going to be our output. Whatever value of x you substitute, f of x is nothing but the output. So which one best or which one must be the following factor? Or among such scenarios, when you have to find out the function represented by among these values, what is given, the best one is to always go with the 0 one. What among these fractions, which one I should take the value of x such that my output is 0? So the best is x minus 4 is equals to 0. You don't have to go for each value of x and check whether I'm getting it or not. Just look at that particular thing. Wherever 0 is there, try and just insert it in place of this one, that your input, and you should get the output as 0. So 4 minus 4 is 0. Finish. Job done. Whereas no other polynomial over here will give you that. It is as simple as that. Now, the line y equals to kx plus 4, where k is constant, is graphed in the xy plane. Okay, just like y is equal to mx plus c form, where k is nothing but it's acting like a slope. If the line contains point cd, what is the slope of the line in terms of c and d? So if you can replace it, what it would be? That's what the question is asking us. So as I said, we need to just work it out in terms of c and d. So we have a line. First of all, we need to check what is given to us. Y is equals to kx plus 4 is the line, okay, where k is the slope, which is a constant. So now if the point, if the line contains that point, means that line is a part of, that line belongs to that, that point belongs to that line. So just in that, that point c comma d is nothing but this is x and y, because if it lies on the line, so basically this becomes your x and y. So replace here, your y will be d and your x is c. So which one would be the best option here? C. D minus 4 by c is equals to k. So which option is there? The first option. The constant k represented in terms of c and d. Since remember that they have given a point and the point line, the line contains the point. So basically that becomes your x and y. So I substituted in x and y and to get the constant k. So just, I just shifted it here. Positive makes negative, okay. Then it was in multiplication. We know the reciprocal is division. That's how you have to do it. Moving on to the next one. In the system of equations above, where k is a constant and x and y are variables, for what value of k will the system of equations have no solutions? As we discussed in our earlier video, there are three options that we have for system of equations. Either you will have one solution when they intersect. No solution means there is only one option, that is there, the line should be the parallel. And there is infinitely many solutions when one line overlaps the other one, exactly the same. So here they have given us for what value of k have no solution. So basically the lines have to be parallel. And when they are parallel, what happens? The slope remains same. So we have to try and think in that way. So kx minus 3y is equals to 4. And we need to work it out. K is a constant and x, y are variables. For what value of k? So we need to work out what is k. So if I could shift it the other way, what it would be? Kx minus 3y. So y is equals to k by 3 minus 4 by 3. Now, similarly for this equation, 4x minus 5y is equals to 7. If you have to shift it the other way, remember I am trying to make this equation in terms of y is equal to mx plus c, where m is the nothing but the slope. So 4x minus 7 is equals to 5y, and y is equals to 4 by 5x minus 7 by 5. If you can relate it, y is equal to mx plus c, whereas this will be our slope. They asked for what value of k. So we should be concerned with this only, as it is no solution. Thus lines are parallel, so the slope will be same. So k by 3 is equals to 4 by 5. So it would be nothing but 3 times 4, 12, 12 by 5. A would be my answer. Moving on to the 10th one. In the xy plane, the parabola with equation y is equal to x minus l 11 whole square intersects a line with the equation y equals to 25. At two points A and B, what is the length of AB? So as we know, when we plot, let us say y is equals to 25 is over here, positive it is, so it would definitely be on top, on the positive side of the y-axis. But here you have to be very careful when you draw the graph of y is equal to x minus, because if it is negative within the bracket, it means it shifts towards the right side. If it is positive, the graph shifts towards the left side of the x-axis. So it means the graph is like that. Remember, it touches, so it has to be 11 over here. We need to work out and get the two points A and B. Okay, two points. What is the length of that? What is the length of this one? That we have to work it out. So what I'm going to do, if you can see here, y and y. So there are two my equations and left hand side is equal. So I'm going to directly equate the two. So if I going to equate, what happens here? If I shift the power, it will be like square root, radical. So we know the sign of that is positive and negative. So one time I'll take positive and one time I'll take the negative. So if I take, what I'm going to get, 5 plus 11, that is 16. And next time I'm going to get is positive 16. And this values, if you substitute here, you will get your corresponding points and you can easily get your x. So as we got our x values as 16 and 6, and since we are focusing on, let's say this is A and this is B, so this is 6 and this is 16, that's what we got. So we need to work it out, the distance. Okay, what is the length basically, this one? So 6 and 16, what is the length? It will be 16 minus 6, that is 10. Bingo, that is your answer. Moving on to the next one. The figure is given to us, intersecting lines, okay, where K, L, M are line which are intersecting, and the relationship, remember what is given to us, is x plus y is equals to u plus w. And we know when the lines intersect, we have that VOA, the vertically opposite angles are equal. So we'll try and just relate it, what all angles will be equal. So this y will be equal to u, okay, z is equal to w, and x is equals to t. That is what we have. But as such, they have given us an expression which is like x plus y is equal to this one. If you could see here, y is equals to u. So y is equal to u means, so this goes out. It means we have, from the expression, we have x is equals to w. So now, which one is true, they are asking among this one. The best one is, you just notice over here, which two things are equal. See, x is equals to w and w is equals to c. So it means basically, this two rules out, we have x is equals to said option. Moving on to the next 12th one. Y is equals to a times x minus 2 times x plus 4. So in the quadratic equation above, a is a non-zero constant. The graph of the equation in the xy plane is a parabola with vertex c and d. Which of the following is equal to d? Okay, we need to work it out and get what would be our d. So first thing, you have two points. So how do you plot it? So positive means we'll come to the negative side of x, as we know. and this negative means it is this one. So as it is a parabola, so it could be like this, or it could be like this. Yeah, but how to get that center one? I mean, this one is pi, doing it minus 4 plus 2 over 2, which will give us negative 1. So when my x is negative, I need to plug it in over here, negative 1 plus 4. And in order to get that, negative 1 minus 2. So which basically means my y is equals to a times negative 3 times 4 minus 1 is 3. So which means negative 9a. Check where is your this one. This is your answer. Now moving on to this one. What is the value of a? The equation is given to us. Okay, so we have another my expression, which is looking very difficult and different. But in order to proceed for this question, what you have to do is you check the denominator, what you have, that is ax minus 2 and ax minus 2. So you definitely need to take LCM over here to work it out and simplify. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just times it with ax minus 2 to the entire equation. So this means if I multiply this with ax minus 2 here, I'm going to do it here. Similarly, this entire thing have to be multiplied with ax minus 2. So what happens is that this and this goes out, you are left with the numerator 24x squared plus 25x minus 47 is equal to this times this one, that is ax minus 2 times negative 8x minus 3 minus 53. Okay, we are not going to do the entire thing and waste our time. Just equate your x square term, which you will get it by multiplying these two binomials. Okay, for what value of a, so that it becomes 24, because that's how we have to do. When you multiply it, your coefficient of x square, x and entire thing should be equal. So that number is nothing but negative 3, because negative 8 is over here. Negative 8 and negative 3 will give you positive 24. So your answer is for a is going to be negative 3. You don't have to work it out with the entire expression. Moving on to the next one. What are the solutions to 3x squared plus 12x plus 6? Since you have first, whenever question is given, quadratic equation, and you need to work out the solution, just check whether can you divide this or can you take out something common. I can do this entire equation with 2, dividing by 3 will give me x squared plus 4x plus 2 equals to 0. Now, there aren't any factors of 2, okay, when you split up to get 4 in the middle. So we are going to do with the quadratic, as we are very well aware. This is the formula that we have, quadratic. Just substitute these terms that we have, negative 4 plus or minus b squared, that is 16 minus 4 times 1 and 2. Means a is 1 coefficient of x and c is 2 divided by 2 times 1. So negative 4 plus or minus and root 16 minus 8 is nothing but 8, which means negative 4 plus or minus, I can write 8 as 2 to 2. Now, if I take 2 common from here, my answer is done. That is 2 plus or minus root 2 over 2. So this answer is negative 2 with 2. Take this one. So this will be negative 2 plus or minus root 2. So A is your solution. Moving on to the next one over here. We know this formula very well. It is given in the centigrade. Celsius and Fahrenheit. The equation shows above a temperature F, the relationship between the Celsius and the Fahrenheit to measure the temperature. Most of the part of India, Asian subcontinent, they go with Celsius. Mostly the abroad countries like US, Canada, and all the European countries, they go with the Fahrenheit. We need to work out and check which of the following must be true. Among this, the scenario, the situation is given to yours. A temperature increase of 1 degree Fahrenheit is equivalent to a temperature of 5 by 9, or 1 degree Celsius is equivalent to a temperature of 1.8, or this one. So what I'm going to do is, I'm not going to solve it just like that. I'm just simply going to plug it in over here so that what makes us entire expression gives me zero. So if I substitute 32 here, I'm going to get the entire answer as zero, because I took F as 32. Remember, a temperature increase of 1 degree Fahrenheit. So I thought okay, better to make it as equal to zero. So now C is zero. What if I increase this by one, that is 33? What happens? This becomes 5/9, which is obviously correct, equivalent to this one. Now, similarly, if I change this setup and make my C as zero instead of F as zero, like this entire thing, we substituted F as zero. What if I check now or change this to C in terms of F basically? So this will become 9C, okay, 9/5C plus 32 is equals to F. What if I make this as zero by substituting? What will give me F as zero? So then definitely your answer is going to be 1.9. Excuse me, sorry. So these two options is quite okay. You can select these two options. Moving on to the next one, next set of questions that we have. If x is positive greater than zero, what is one possible solution to the equation above? Now, as I said, 1 and 2 is the answer. In the shortcut, we can do it quickly, but maybe many of you might still be wondering, okay, how we got it. So better to do this one. I'll just explain you how to do that. As I said, we tried and change F as 32 and decrease by 1, we get 5/9. Now, similarly, this relationship what we have, we can easily convert that in terms of F. Like we have a relationship now in terms of C to F. We can do that from F to C so that we can make F as a subject basically. So this F will be, when you try and shift it the other side, you can observe this becomes 9/5. Okay, this becomes what, 9/5 into C and then plus 32. So if I change this as negative 32, my F would be zero. And as they said, increase by one. So negative 32 means increase will be not negative 33, it has to be negative 31. So if you substitute negative 31 here, what you're going to get? Negative 31 plus 32 means will give you 9/5. And you know what is 9/5 will give you? It is nothing but 1.8. That's the reason I told you that 1 and 2 options are correct. I hope you have understood it. Now moving on to the next one. We have x cubed into times x square minus 5, this one. So if you can just multiply this one, so you get x raised to 5 minus 5x cubed is equals to negative 4x, bringing it over here, plus 4x to make it entire one set of equation in terms of x. Now, if I divide this entire thing with x, what I'm going to get is x raised to 4 minus 5x square plus 4 equals to 0. Now, if I could split, I know the factors of 4 times 1, so that I can split this one quickly. So x raised to 4 minus 4x square minus 1x square plus 4, which can further be written as x square whole square, okay, minus 4x square minus 1x square plus 4. So this will basically give me, I can easily sum it up like x square minus 4 times x minus 2 or x minus 1. So this will give me x square minus 2. If I rearrange the terms, I will get it quickly. You don't have to work out and do everything. Remember, I can take one common over here. So I'm going to get x square minus 1 equals to 0. So the answer would be x square minus 4. So answer would be plus or minus 2. And this is going to be plus or minus 1. But they have asked specifically greater than 0. What is one possible solution? So you can either take plus 1 and plus 1 as well as plus 2. Positive 1 and positive 2. Moving on to the next one. 7x/9 minus 4/9. Is equals to 1/4 plus 5/12. What is the value of x? 7 minus 4 is 5x/9. as they are like term with that common denominator, we can directly do. What about this one is LCM is 12, so times it with 3 to the numerator as well as to the denominator. So we get 3 plus 5, 8 over 12. Now they asked what is x. So x is equals to 8 over 12 times. You can take this entire thing to the other side, or basically reciprocal, or else just write multiply n by 5. So 3 times 4, 4 times 1, 2. So basically x is nothing but 6 over 5. That's it. Moving on to the next one. We have a figure which is given to us, not on scale, but two isosceles triangle as two sides are equal for both the triangle. Y is already given in the question as 75. So quickly write it down, 75 degree. We need to work out and get this exterior angle of the isosceles. We know when two sides of the isosceles triangle are same, the sides with the base are also, the angle with the which they make with the base is also equal. So this is X. So what is Z? So here is the relationship that we have. 180 minus Z is equal to twice of what is Y. Is Y is given as 75 degree, which will give me 150. 180 minus Z. Remember, we are working out with Z now. So if I shift it the other side, so 150 minus 180 minus Z is equal to 150 minus 180 will give me negative 30. So it means if my Z is 30, what would be the other X so that we should get the exterior? So we know the sum of the angles of a triangle is 2X, X plus X I'm directly adding, plus 30 is equals to 180. So in order to get X, I should subtract 30 from 180. So basically 150. So this x has to be 75, because twice of x, these two x together is 150, 75. Then what about this x? We know this is nothing but the linear, 180 degree straight angle. So 75 means 180 minus 75 will give us 105. The value of x is, exterior angle is 105 degree. Moving on to the next set of questions, what we have. At a lunch stand, each hamburger has 50 more calories than each order of fries. If two hamburgers are and three orders of fries have a total of 1700 calories, how many calories does a hamburger have? So this question you have to do with the simultaneous equation. So the question has to be done with the simultaneous equations, as I said earlier. So each hamburger has 50 more calories. So H is equal to 50 more calories than the fries. We will take the relationship in terms of, we'll call that hamburger as H. We'll take in the initials. And then two hamburgers, remember, 2H and three orders of fries is adding up to 1700 calories. So this is what the relationship that you have. Now, in order to make it in the equation form, just subtract H from both sides. So you get H minus F is equals to 50. But as I told you earlier, okay, when we try and solve the simultaneous equations, what the students have to look at, they have to do, there are three methods. So I either one will give you the same answer. But I'm trying to do with the elimination. So by making the coefficients equal, basically. So I can multiply this entire with 2, keeping this 2h intact. So this is 2h minus 2, and this is 50. 50 times 2 is 100. So let us write the new one after multiplying what it will give us. So 2h minus 2f is equals to 100. So this is nothing but 1600 upon subtracting. Why do we have to subtract? Because they are same, in order to cancel, because we are using the elimination. And as I said, the sign of the town will definitely change. If it is negative, positive, positive, negative. So 3 plus 2 is 5. So f is going to give me, if I divide with 5, what happens? 5 times 3 is 15, 1. So this is going to be 320. That is fries, but I need how many calories? The calories for fries is 320. And for the hamburger will be how much now? 320 plus 50. Just substitute over here, because they say hamburger is 50 more. That is nothing but 370 calories. Moving on to the last set of questions that we have. In a triangle ABC, measure Okay, so this question, we have a triangle. The measure of angle B is 90. So we'll just quickly come to the triangle, right angle triangle. Okay, let us call it as A, B, C. That is what is given. And the side BC and AC is this one. So AC is 20, this is 60. And he said there is another triangle which is similar. Okay, there's a similar triangle. So let's draw it as smaller. DEF, which is 1/3. This is what your clue is. 1/3. So if it is 20, this has to be 20/3. And we need to focus on this one because they said sine F we have to calculate. So each side is 1/3 of it, as it is a similar triangle. So what would be the missing side? Missing side can be found by using the Pythagoras theorem, you know, Pythagoras property or the right angle property, that we have hypotenuse square is equals to sum of the other sides, square of the other sides. So 20 square is equals to 16 square plus the x, which we have to work it out. 400 minus this one will give us 144. 144 is nothing but quickly we can do 12. So it is nothing but 12/3. They have asked us specifically to calculate sine, as we know the right angle triangle, that we have the relationship for the trigonometric ratio sine SOHCAHTOA thing. Okay, SOHCAHTOA. So sine is opposite over hypotenuse. Now with respect to this F, the opposite side is 12/3 and hypotenuse is this one. So just quickly write 12/3 and 20/3. So this goes out. So what you are left is 12/20, which can be further simplified as 4 × 3 and 4 × 5. So it is nothing but the value of sine F is 3/5. So by that, we have covered the questions for SAT math practice test 3. I hope you have liked the video and understood the concept. If there is anything, please do write down the comments. I hope you like the video. Please like, share, and subscribe.